Today's practice will be a 60-minute vinyasa flow, and the peak postures will be focusing on the spine, and this practice is called fluid spine. So to start, we're going to start in a supported bridge. So you can use a block. If you don't have a block, you could use even a pillow, or you could use two blocks, just depending on that, how that feels. So start setting up in bridge position. Feet are hip width, fingertips can just touch the heels. And then once you're in that position, lift the hips and place your block underneath the flat part of your spine, the sacral area. And again, if you want a little bit more, you can double stack the blocks. Just bringing the hands either to your sides, or you can cactus them out. And come back to that one block position. From here, we'll start our practice with some breath work. So as you inhale in through your nose, if that's available, fill it all the way up, and then exhale through your mouth, squeezing out every last drip of air. Inhaling to fill up. And exhale. Continue this breath work for another three full breaths. Just letting your body relax into this posture, preparing for your practice. From supported bridge, extend your legs. They're going to come into kind of an arrow star position. If this doesn't feel good, you can bring the knees back to bent. Otherwise, extend your hands over your head, just kind of a mini back bend, lengthening from head to toe. A couple breaths here. And then bending both knees, go ahead and lift up, remove the block, set it to the side, and we're going to do a few flowing bridges here. So again, the setup is the same. Fingertips just graze the heels, knees are about hip width. But this version, as we flow, you're going to inhale, lift everything up, hands up overhead, hips high, and then start to lower your neck, upper back, mid-back, and then before the lower back hits the floor, the hands find their way to the floor. Inhale, everything lifts. Exhale, articulate the spine. Finishing with the hands down. A couple more times. Lift. And articulate. Last one. Lift everything up, lower down one vertebra at a time, finishing with the hands on the floor. And taking it a bit deeper into a bridge pose. So as you inhale, lift the hips and keep the hands down this time. You can stay here, or you can roll the shoulder blades underneath your back. Interlace the hands and squeeze onto that shoulder shelf. Trying to keep your thigh bones parallel, and if your neck bugs you a little bit, turn your chin a little bit towards the ceiling. Breathe. And gently releasing the shoulders, and one last time articulating the spine back down. From here, bring both knees one at a time into your chest. Give yourself a little low back massage here, rolling out the ankles. Maybe even through the hips, figure eight. Then bring both knees into your chest. Extend your legs up your imaginary wall. Maybe grab the backs of your thighs or your calves. You can roll out your ankles. Maybe even give your hamstrings a little massage. From here, slightly bend your knees. Lift your head and chest and wrap your arms around your legs. You can bend the knees a little more, curl up into a little ball, rolling, creating that C curve in the lower back. And then releasing the hands to the thighs, just come up and over into a tabletop shape. And we're going to create a tabletop shape that has knees together and hands a little bit wide. Drop your head and chest. Let your head just relax, let your neck relax, maybe tuck your toes. Chakra Vikasana, side to side, or start to come into little circles. And then making them bigger. Pressing into your toes on your way back. Any tight spots, you can find a little bit more of a longer hold in those tight spots. And then let's meet in a tabletop shape that's aligned. So you're going to spread your fingers, bring your knees underneath your hip bones. As you inhale, drop your belly, lift open through your heart. As you exhale, tuck and round. Ujjayi Pranayama, that's available. Inhaling through the nose. Soft through the lips, and then exhale through the nose. Inhale. And exhale. One more inhale. And exhale. Coming into a neutral spine. Work the wrists before we come into that first down dog. Put the fingertips towards you. Again, you can tuck the toes. Maybe circle around the wrists. And then find a little movement back and forth. And then hold the stretch in the wrists. Maybe move your thumbs forward a little bit. Then bending your elbows, get your fingers a little bit. From here, you can roll it out. Maybe make a fist, open it up. And spend a moment or two with some pressure on the tops of your hands. And from here, when you are ready, try to create that L shape in the thumb and index finger as your hips go high. Pedal it out. Here, let's do a little bit of a spinal wave. So from your down dog position, inhale as you come to your tiptoes, lean with your shoulders, come into a plank position. Then bend your knees, wave it back to downward dog. So with one full breath, inhale to plank, exhale, wave it back. Last one, inhale. The knees, wave it back. Then bend both knees, press your chest towards your thigh bones, broaden your collarbone, and walk your hands back to meet your feet. for ragdoll. Take a moment to find the four corners of your feet. Bend the knees as much as you need to here. You can start with the hands on the floor. Maybe find a little bit of movement. Maybe keep your hands on the floor or even a block. From here, if it's available, you can interlace the hands, grab opposite elbows. Check in with your neck, make sure there's no tension. Let your eyes relax, jaw relax. And really trying to send your tailbone to the sky so that hinge in the hips is turning your tailbone towards the sky. Just give yourself a few breaths here to let go of that resistance in the hamstrings and in the spine. And if it feels good, go ahead and sway. Option maybe a little bit of neck traction. Interlace the hands behind the base of your skull and just let the weight of your hands, the weight of your arms create a little traction. Release your hands to the floor, soften the knees, and roll it up nice and slow, one vertebra at a time. Once you're up, let's do a couple shoulder rolls back, shoulder rolls forward. And inhale the arms up. Little cactus, just the upper back opens. And then interlace your hands behind the base of your lower tailbone. Press the knuckles towards the mat. Inhale. And then as you exhale, send the hips back, bending the knees just a little bit. Let the hands fall over your head. Gently release the hands to the lower back and then to the mat. And then if your feet are wider, bring them back to underneath your hip bones. And you're just going to lay down one hand at a time, walking it out to plank. Once you get to plank, pushing the floor away, always have the option to bring the knees down. From here, hinge forward under your toes or from your knees and lower all the way down to the mat. You can do a few cobras here. So keeping your hands under your shoulders, point your toes, navel to spine. Inhale, push into the floor just to where it feels good to the lower back. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Last one here, inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Tuck your toes under. You can stay on your knees or lift the kneecaps, high plank. Press it back to downward facing dog. So in today's practice, I'm going to show you a variation of vinyasa that we're going to do to focus on the spine. So we'll come to plank, and you always, again, you can bring the knees down and do this variation, okay? From the knees, it looks like this. You're going to come to chaturanga, and then send your hips high, bring your knees, chest, and chin to the floor. And then pull yourself forward into cobra. Exhale, lowering down. Tuck the toes. Again, you can come back up to the knees or lift it. Back to downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees. Look to the top of your mat, step forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale to fold. Lift the palms to rise up. Inhale. Let's steeple grip the hands. Right. And exhale to the right. Inhale back to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale back to center. Cactus the arms. Open the heart. Keep this in the upper back. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Plant your hands. High plank. You can stay on the toes like I am or bring your knees down. Chaturanga pause. Bring the knees down, send the hips high, knees chest chin. Inhale, Bhujangasana Cobra. Exhale, lower. Inhale, plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's inhale the right leg high. Hug the knee into your nose. Tiptoes of the left foot, hollow up the belly. Step the foot on the inside of your right thumb. Once your feet are set, make sure your knees over your ankle. Bring your left knee down. Press the hip points down. Keeping your core engaged. Walk your hands up to your right knee. As you straighten your arms, you're going to create space in the side body. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, press the hips forward, core engaged, cactus the arms, open the heart. Frame your right foot, send it back, half hananana. You might have to drag your right heel towards you a little bit to square up the hips. Lengthen, and you can always use the blocks under your hands and fold over that right hamstring. You can stay up on the left knee or come down like I am. Forward into low lunge, left hand down, right hand high, full circle. So you're going to sweep the arm to the back of the room, fingertips on the floor, all the way around that shoulder socket, and then switch directions. Holding the arms at 12 and 6 o'clock, and then the option here, the back foot stays the same, but maybe come to the knife edge of the right foot, and then cactus the arm open. Start to come back around. Set your feet to warrior two. Right toes straight forward, left foot's parallel to the back of the mat. Then walk your hands to the far right corner of your space. Spread your fingers so your arms look like down dog. And then press the chest through the gateway of your shoulders. Still externally rotating through your right hip, moving the right knee towards the back of your space. Let's walk it back. Into the center position, bringing the feet parallel into wide leg forward fold. Just a few breaths here, a little micro bend in the knees to keep them safe. Walk the hands out in front of you under your shoulders, little halfway lift. Inhale, and as you exhale, walk to the back of your space. Low lunge, plant your hands. High plank, again on the toes or the knees. Chaturanga pause. Drop the knees, send the hips high, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, lower. Inhale, plank. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, left leg high. Tippy toes of the right foot, hug it in, hollow out the belly. Step it through, low lunge. Bring the right knee down. Press the hips down. Pull the heart forward. Core is super engaged, so there's no pressure in the lower back. Then walk the hands up to the left knee. Straighten the arms. Create space in the side body. Hold that space in the side body. Inhaling, arms up. And cactus. Frame your left foot, straighten the left leg, and come into half hananana here. So lifting through the sternum again, maybe drag the left heel to square up the hips, and just try to do the variation that you did on the other side. If this is hard, and the floor's far away, use your blocks. Come forward to low lunge, right hand down, left hand high, backstroke, and then switch directions. Holding the arms at 12 and 6, cactus the left arm, feet to warrior two, walk to the far left corner, set the down dog hands, and press the chest through the gateway of your shoulders. Be super strong with the legs, moving the left knee towards the back of your space. And then let's walk it back to that center, prasarita, wide leg forward fold, maybe this time grab the outsides of the feet. Using your biceps to create a little bit more space in the hamstrings. Walk the hands out underneath. Inhale, this time we're going to walk to the left foot. Grab your left foot with your right hand. Inhale, the left arm high. You can also do this with the right hand in the center. Come back to center, hands on your shoulders, inhale halfway. Again, you can walk the hands, left hand to your foot, right hand high, or left hand in the center, right hand high. So release back to that fold. Walk the hands out, straight out. Set them up. As you inhale, come to your tippy toes. Shoulders stacked over your wrists, and then press it back. Back a little traction here. Broaden your collarbone. Let your head just hang. Walk the hands underneath your shoulders. Halfway lift. Walk it back to the front. High plank. Chaturanga. Knees, chest, chin. Inhale, cobra, shoulders are back and down. Lower, high plank to downward facing dog. Couple breaths here. Inhale, the right leg high. Exhale to low lunge. Left hand down, right hand cactus this time. Walk it around, warrior two feet, stretch it out, far right corner. Walk it to the center, feet become parallel, and fold. Walk your hands underneath your shoulders, I'm going to change it up here. Draw your navel to your spine, send your hips back in space, and bring your arms up parallel to the floor. Little right bend in the knees. Inhale, rise up, turn your toes out, interlace the hands behind you, and sink into goddess. So the elbows are moving back in space, so are your knees. Inhale, as you exhale, bring your right knee and elbow towards each other. Inhale, center, left knee. Inhale, center. All right, for this, we're gonna twist to the side, coming into a hovering crescent moon, okay? Now move your elbows back in space, super strong here, draw the ribs together. As you straighten the back leg, hinge forward. Keep moving the elbows back. Inhale, drop the right elbow towards the inside of your left foot. And then bring the hand down, left hand high. Stay here or come into fallen lizard. And coming out of the knife edges of both feet, reaching the left arm back. Coming back to center, high plank, chaturanga, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, bhujangasana. Exhale, lower. Inhale, plank. Exhale, down, facing dog. Inhale, the left leg high. All the way through, low lunge. Right hand planted, just little cactus of the left arm. Warrior two feet, walk to the far left corner. to the center and fold. Bring the hands under your shoulders, navel to spine, arms parallel, shoulders in their sockets, tailbone set back. Inhale, toes point out, star, interlace the hands behind the base of your head. Sink into goddess. Keep pulling the elbows and knees back. Inhale. Left elbow, left knee. Inhale, center. Right elbow, right knee, center. And then we're gonna turn to the side. All right, little hover. Keep moving elbows back in space. And then straighten the back leg, hover. Inhale, left elbow, then hand, then fallen lizard. Or you can stay in that twisted position, twisted low lunge. Let's come back to center. Step the feet together at the top of the mat this time, and fold. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, anhala, and move your hands to heart. We'll go through that flow one more time. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. High plank, toes or knees. Chaturanga. Knees, chest, chin. Inhale, Bhujangasana. Exhale, lower. Plank to downward dog. Inhale, right leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, cactus twist. Exhale, monkey warrior two, reach. Walk it to the middle and fold. Inhale, hands under shoulders. Exhale, reach. Inhale, interlace the hands, toes point out, goddess. Inhale, exhale, right elbow towards the knee. Inhale, center, exhale. Inhale, center, exhale, pivot into that hovering crescent moon. Breathe. Straighten the back leg, hinge forward. Right elbow towards the right, fallen lizard. And three, we'll come back around. Two, and one. High plank, chaturanga, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, Bhujangasana. Exhale, inhale, exhale. All right, coming back, left side. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, little lunge. Inhale, twist with the cactus. Warrior two, reach. Walk it to the center and fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, reach. Inhale, star. Exhale, goddess. Inhale. Exhale to the left. Inhale, center. Exhale to the right. Inhale, center. And pivot. Find your stability here. Inch forward, elbow reaches, then hand, and then fall into lizard. Let's come back around, high plank, chaturanga, up dog, to downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees, step to the top of your space. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, mountain. Hands to heart. All right, we've got one more flow series. It's going to challenge your balance. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway. Plant your hands, step back to plank. And this time, we'll just do the wave back. So bend your knees, wave it back. To downward facing dog. Inhale, the right leg high. Low lunge. Place the weight on foot, bring it up, one leg to asana. Once you have your balance, straighten the left leg and twist to the left. Inhaling, rebend, Ardha Chandrasana half moon. You're gonna bend, maybe put your hand on a block, right? And then bring your left hand high. And then just to get a little bit deeper into the pose, bring your left hand to your hip, turn your hip open, lift your left leg, then re-extend the left arm. In five, we'll come back to warrior two. Four, three, two, and one. Step it back, fix any crashes. Shoulders and hips are square to knee. Inhale, reverse. Your hand can go to your thigh or wrap. Recommit a little more to that right knee. Inhale. As you exhale, either elbow to knee, hand to a block or the floor. Left hand either to the sky or sweeping over the ear line. Heading to reverse triangle, reach up through the left hand, straighten your right leg, high five the back wall. Rebending the right knee, you're gonna step it forward into Uttanasana, forward fold. Maybe grab the backs of your calves. Plant your hands, high plank, wave it back, downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, one leg, Tadasana. Ayurvedic, that's your focal point, your balance. When you're ready, straighten the leg and open to the right. Rebend the left knee. Ardha Chandrasana, half moon, hand to the floor or a block. Once you're stable, right hand to your right hip, open and lift. And maybe the left hand, I'm sorry, the right hand reaches up. In five, four, three, two, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Next, exhale, extended elbow, block or floor. Reverse Trikonasana, reach. We bend the left knee, step it together and fold. All right, we're gonna do it one more time, both sides. Inhale, halfway, high plank, toes or knees, chaturanga, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, Bhujangasana, exhale, lower, plank. And now dog. All right, a little more fluid. Inhale, right leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, one leg Tadasana. Exhale, twist. Inhale, rebound. Exhale, Ardha Chandrasana. Option is sugar cane. So you grab the big toe this time and extend. Keeping a little micromanaging your right knee. Release. Step it back. Warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, extend. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, Uttanasana fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Plant the hands. High plank. Chaturanga. Knees, chest, chin, Bhujangasana, lower, inhale, plank, exhale, down dog. All right, left side, inhale, left leg, little lunge, inhale, one leg, Tadasana, exhale, twist, inhale, rebend, exhale, Ardha Chandrasana, and again, you can do the sugarcane variation. Release. Set warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, extend. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, forward fold. Come into a little ball. And then all the way onto your back. And start with your knees into your chest. A little bit of belly up core. So from here, you're going to set up like you would bridge. Fingertips behind the ears. You're going to lift your hips. And then crunch straight up, alternating the legs. If that's too much, keep the hips down. All right, five, four, three, two, and one. Set the hips down, come into Supta Baddha, butterfly position. Bring your hands again behind your ears. Lift your head and chest. Now lower back is down. There's no space there. You're going to inhale in this lifted position. Exhale, lift it higher. Now you can lift the feet a couple inches to make it harder. Open mouth, exhale. 10, 9, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now hold up high. Now press into your toes and lift your feet. Right elbow, right knee. Inhale, center. Exhale. Five. Really use the obliques. Four. Three. Lower back and down. Last one. Lower down. Come into Supta Baddha. Hand to your heart, hand to your belly. Couple breaths. From here, extend your arms towards the ceiling. Inhale, and as you exhale, come all the way up to a sit-up. All right, and before we do this next little core section, grab the insides of your ankles, press your knees down, and lift your chest open. Trying to keep the knees down as much as you can without the arms. Extend and reach forward. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, one vertebra at a time, lower it down. You're going to end up with the hands facing the ceiling. Then keeping this position, keeping your feet together, lift your hips. Lower back down. Inhale. Exhale to sit up. Inhale here. Hold the knees down. And reach. Reach. Keep your neck long. Five, four, three, two, and one. Inhale, and then lower down. One vertebra at a time. Really hard once you get to the lower back. And then bridge lift, hips high, squeeze. Five, four, three, two, and one. Inhale, lower the hips. Exhale to come up. Inhale here. Exhale to reach, last one. This time, super slow, articulating down. Bring it back to center. Nice and slow this time. Do the best you can. One vertebra at a time. Until you come all the way down. Bring your hands on the outsides of your thighs. Bring your feet as wide as your mat. Let's just do a couple windshield wipers. Thank you. more wheel pose. So for wheel, you're going to set up just like bridge, right? Feet hip width, fingertips can graze the heels. From here, bring your hands so your fingertips are facing forward. All right, and then on an inhale, just come up to your head. Next exhale, bring it up. Breathe, it's hard to breathe here. When you do come down, chin to chest, shoulders down, and windshield wiper back and forth. Now, if you didn't want to do wheel, you could always do bridge. But we're going to do one more. And if you're tired, you can always do that supported bridge with the block underneath your sacrum like we did at the very beginning. All right, set up for the second one. Feet hip width. Hands, fingertips back. Hair in the way. Come up to your head. Inhale. And then exhale to press it up. Take your time. And enjoy wiper. Just windshield wipering. Alright, so your feet are as wide as your mat when you're doing these windshield wipers. And the next time you come with your knees facing the right, stay there. You can cactus out the arms, or you can bring the hands to your legs or hips, wherever your arms want to go. Maybe gaze towards your left hand. And then once again, windshield wiper, side to side, really getting some length and some movement through the spine, through the hips. Face the left, stay there, and again, maybe gaze towards the right hand. The ceiling, bring your knees into your chest, and roll around on the lower back. Now bringing the knees in through the chest. So I want this section to be without hands. So bring your hands into that cactus shape. Flex your feet and bring your right. You're going to come into figure four. So your right ankle is clearing your left thigh bone and you're flexing both feet. From here, move your right knee towards the front of your space and then drag your left knee towards you. There's a lot going on here, a lot of energy. So energetically pull that left knee towards you. Breathe. And with your right hand, you're going to grab the inside of your right foot and straighten the left leg. Lower your left leg down and come into half dead baby. So you're going to lower the left leg down, bring the right thigh bone on the outside of your right ribs. All right, from here, play around with bending and straightening that right leg. little supine twist exercise here. So starting from that half happy baby, you can start to straighten the leg, or if it's not perfectly straight, come around, tapping your left hand with your right foot. So your left arm is out in a T. Back to half dead bug, and all the way over to the tap. Three times, one more, inhale, and exhale. Let's come back to center. Bring both knees, let's reach back a little bit, into your chest, and we'll set for the other side. Cactus the arms, left ankle clears the right thigh bone, draw your left knee towards the front of your space, and then energetically pull your right knee towards you, flexing both feet. Breathe. Grab the inside of your left foot, straighten the right. Half dead bug, right leg down, point or straighten and rebend. Move into dead bug.